KP! KP in the house! You already know how to bounce!
No shot!
It's Disney Detonation coming at you from the Transformative Content for You Studios in New Jersey on a rainy NFL Sunday, December 3rd. I'm trying to get out of here before 1, and it's 1 now. I want to watch the games, and I'm late. I had a family member go in the hospital on Monday, come out on Thursday, but don't worry, everything's fine. And there's just so much in the way of KP content. So how I normally work this is I'll screen capture as I watch his channel and then throw it in a folder and then sift through the folder. So there's just so much to go through. Like, it's hard to decide what to keep and what not. And there's no really theme the past week or so except for the Cancun trip. And so I'm going to start out with this. I thought this was pretty interesting or pretty funny. He's out of breath at the driving range. So this is called Out of Breath at the Driving Range.
Well, that was rough. That was rough. I mean, for just doing it this year, I feel like I'm decent. But we'll see how it translates onto the course. That's where it really matters, you know?
I mean, unless he ran around the golf cart before he turned the camera on, like, how are you out of breath driving balls at a driving range? All right. So the next clip is called It's All About Me.
Can't wait to see the grass. The leaves are still turning. It's beautiful. Kevin's over there. He didn't want to be with us.
You guys are standing in front of the door.
You dick. I mean, can you imagine? He was at the airport, the Raleigh airport, going to visit his future in-laws or whatever, and he's videotaping himself standing in front of the doorway. Like, what? I mean, whatever. All right. So the next clip is called A KP Thanksgiving. Now, I thought this was pretty funny. I mean, so Casey did set the table, and it basically looked like the kids' table at a regular Thanksgiving, which was kind of odd to me considering, like, if you look to the left in the room, there's a beautiful dining room table. I guess maybe they didn't have a sleeve to extend the table or they had too many people. I have no idea, but it just struck me as odd they had a dining room, but yet they didn't use the dining room. And then I kind of compared it to JoJo's, tablescape as well. So here it goes. It's called a KP Thanksgiving.
Case is setting the table. She did the roses. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. And the plates, too. Good placement, Casey. Those were good.
He's trying to make it look a little bit more like a thing.
I mean, he talks to her like she's a child.
Thanksgiving tablescape.
All right, guys. I think Casey's finished with Thanksgiving dinner, or technically lunch. What you did so good.
Thank you. I just did a simple tablescape. We are using what we had, so it doesn't all match, but you know what? I think it looks pretty cute.
That's what happens when two people are moving in and one is moving out. Jeet's already kind of moving on in.
All right. So the next clip is called Laundry Day. So this genius decides to record himself pontificating about the nuances of Buffalo Wild Wings food while his dryer is running in the background. I mean, he's the one who's putting this stuff out here. It's not like I'm finding it somewhere. It's from him. This is called Laundry Day.
Order Buffalo Wild Wings every Sunday. And it's really interesting, too, because I've learned that their boneless wings are actually better than their bone wings.
Who gives a shit? Who gives a fuck?
At least when you get it delivered, their bone-in wings are terrible when they get delivered. I feel like they give you the scraps, but their boneless is pretty good. Freaking love it to death. I love getting Buffalo Wild Wings, but...
Oh, good for you!
Laundry. I don't know if you guys can hear it. It's in the laundry room right now, or it's in the dryer.
Compelling.
Making the dryer noises. Fun stuff, right?
Day.
What a boob. All right, so the next clip is called KP the Stand-Up Comic. Now, it's like he's got the sense of humor or the sensibilities of a fifth grader with this type of thing. It's outstanding. Here it goes, KP the Stand-Up Comic.
We found the daycare where you guys can put your children when they don't want to go on a slide. It's actually right here. You can put them right there.
Boo. Okay, so the next clip is from their Cancun vacation, which is called Elevated Butter. I mean, this is just spectacular. This one will speak for itself.
It tastes like elevated butter noodles, and I am so happy about it.
Mine tastes like butter noodles too, and I'm okay with that. I throw out butter on everything. I throw butter on my popcorn. I throw butter on my salt. I throw butter on my zucchini. And guess what? I throw butter on my candy.
But I drop in to say hello, boy. Just passing by. You understand it?
Casey's noodles are god tier.
Now, you have a new saying, we understand, and the saying is, that's huge.
Huge. That's huge or huge.
No shot.
Casey's noodles win the event. Unbelievable. I love butter. All right, who's picking up the bill? It's not me. Joke's on you guys. It's all included.
Fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life, son.
What an unbelievable. The arrogance. So, the next two clips are about him and his anniversary gift to KC. Now, all right, so I'm just going to play this. It speaks for itself. It's called A Christmas Anniversary Gift.
I do want to show you what I got KC that was supposed to be with the gift that is not on time anymore. So I think for sure I'm going to go maybe to Target and Hollywood Studios to pick her something up, because I feel bad just giving her this, because the gift that I had was a pretty big gift. Now I'm probably just going to give it to her next week when it comes. I'm going to ask her if she wants it for Christmas.
Not a great plan.
And that's a whole nother thing. So there was a whole bunch of other clips that I had where he pretends that he obviously doesn't give her the, I guess, AirPods or whatever, the headphones on the anniversary day, and gives it to her at the parents' house, or the father-in-law's, his Casey's parents' house, and pretends that he's receiving a drone, and videotapes it and surprises. It's just so utterly ridiculous. Now, all he had to do was just, and I don't know about the rest of you, but this has happened to me before, where I ordered something, it didn't come on time. So what I did, I just took a picture of what I ordered and I put it in the card, you know, and so you can see this is coming for you. But now, what's even better here in this clip, it's called Happy Anniversary, No Bear for You. So he takes a Coke, one of the swag he got from Coke for the 100-year anniversary. He stuffs the T-shirt and his card in the box, and gives, and I have no idea why he would do this. It's just so utterly ridiculous. And then if you listen at the end of this clip, she obviously wants the bear in the box, and he's no intention of giving it to her. So here it goes. Happy anniversary, no bear for you.
And I positioned the gift right in here when she comes on in. Now I'm reusing actually the Coca-Cola thing, because I thought it was so cool. A girl like you needs
something
real.
Special girl. And
then when you open it inside, it's just the gift that we got today, the card, and I couldn't get this out, so she's gonna see a Coca-Cola bear. So that's kind of funny, but yeah, unfortunately that gift didn't come, but we got that. And then of course dinner tonight. This is our anniversary. Just dating anniversary. Sounds like we're married. You like your gift thing?
I love it. I love the use of the Coca-Cola packaging.
Your real gift is coming, hopefully Monday. You can open it. It's just a temporary gift. Just open yours first.
What the hell is a temporary gift? I mean, what?
On camera?
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah, open that Coca-Cola box on camera.
The bear was from the Coke. I didn't want to take it out. I couldn't get this out, so she's going to see a Coca-Cola bear. I couldn't get this out, so...
I bought a T-shirt.
I did.
Oh, when I get this, I get the Coca-Cola bear too?
Well, I didn't want to destroy him because I like this box, so I didn't want to. So I just thought he was cool to sit there. Yeah.
No, you. I mean, like, what? What are you gonna do with a box that big with a Coca-Cola bear? I mean, what? Just give her the bear, dude. It's ridiculous. Wow. All right. So the next clip is called Disney Japan. Now, this other guy, this Tom Corliss, whatever his name is, from WDW News, I can't stand this guy. And actually, one of the other reasons why this video hasn't come out sooner is because I'm putting clips together on this guy. This guy's crazy. He is an egomaniac, and I am definitely going to start doing some videos on him. After the holidays, when the weather starts getting really cold and I have more time to sit in here and screw around, I will have more than one video out per week. So this video is called Disney Japan, like I said before. And the interesting thing is this, unbeknownst to me, so a lot of Disney vloggers or influencers or whatever you want to call them were invited, like literally invited, not like Kalo, Pilo, Pilo, could be the same type of situation, I don't know, were invited to go to Disney Hong Kong and check out this new Frozen Land, and airfare is included and this and that. And what I thought was hilarious was that JoJo's going, there's a couple other vloggers that I put in here are going, and then Kylo Palo Pilo, his thing is he's going to Cancun. I just thought the juxtaposition between these things, is there a connection there? Maybe not. I just thought it was funny. So this is called Disney Japan.
And the same thing's going on with Hong Kong, where they've sent a bunch of people, a bunch of American media, to cover the opening of World of Frozen, and they've paid $0. They haven't paid for flights, which are the most expensive part of going to Hong Kong. They're not paying for the hotel at Explorer's Lodge. They're not paying for any of these things, right?
Gene and I are leaving for China, so...
That is insane. We're going under it. Oh, that's sick. Oh, that's so cool. Hong Kong Disneyland Hotel.
Disneyland Hong Kong.
Ooh!
Konnichiwa, everyone, and welcome back to Ordinary Adventures.
The day is finally here. Today, we are going to Tokyo Disneyland Resort. We're going to be going in style, staying at Tokyo DisneySea Hotel MiraCosta.
We are all the way across the world to explore Hong Kong Disneyland!
I truly don't think we could be more excited.
I know, I'm so excited for today.
We were invited by Disney to Hong Kong to see World of Frozen. Now, we've done that this week, and
And we're headed to Iberostar in Cancun.
I'd say I got roughly about 5 hours of sleep, so we're going to be on a five-hour day. But it's okay. When you're going to Cancun for the first time, the adrenaline kicks in. This is my first time going to Cancun. I think Casey's too.
Now today is a rather big day because it's Casey and I's 1 year anniversary on
I think Casey's too.
So he's been with this girl for a year, which is a whole nother thing that I wanted to get into, because apparently this is the longest relationship he's ever had. A 30-year-old man, and he's been with a person for a year, and if that's not a red flag, I don't know what is. But anyway, he just said, I think this is Casey's first time to Cancun. You think you would have had that conversation prior to booking the vacation, driving? I mean, it's just absurd. So the next clip is, I don't even know what it is. I don't know what this clip is. So I'm just going to play it because I mislabeled it. And here it goes.
Oh my gosh, this is funny. Let's go slurping is what the...
Okay, this is called the invisible drink.
Bar is called here. This is the full service bar. They're all getting drinks. Look at Alexa's banana cabana, which is just rum and rum and rum. Cheers to Kevin's birthday.
Cheers. Happy birthday, Kevin.
Mmm. Drink was good.
Come on, stop your clowning. What's the matter with you? Aren't you ashamed?
I don't know.
Why do you do these things?
I'm a bad pussycat.
I mean, what was the purpose of that? Like he's pretending every... So is he virtue signaling to everyone that he's not driving? Or, I mean, he's driving. He's the designated driver. Why don't you just say, I'm the designated driver. I can't have a... Maybe I missed it in the video, but that is just like some self-serving bullshit. It's just ridiculous. All right, so the next clip is Hello, Kevin. I mean, this was pretty... It speaks for itself. Let's play it. Hello, Kevin.
Kevin the man.
The myth. The legend. Kevin! What up, dog?
What?
What up, dog?
What up?
What up?
Have you prepared a statement for the press?
Well, yes. I have prepared a statement. Get me out of here!
I don't know how he does it. So this is the last clip for this episode, and it's just a mashup of you know, clips, because there was really no rhyme or reason to this this vlog this week. I just tried to get something out because I didn't, like I said, I didn't have a lot of time because I had a family member in the hospital. So this is, I might actually keep doing this. It's called the weekly mashup, because sometimes I can't find a theme, but I have all these clips and they're just kind of like, they're, you know, 15, 20 seconds, maybe sometimes 30. So string them together and make a, you know, a long clip. It's the weekly mashup.
If I'm being honest, I can't believe I'm saying this. I'm actually looking forward to Home Goods.
No shot.
Versus Target today, which is very rare.
Side note.
Guava and I think tequila. Oh, that's a chugger. Oh, that's a chugger.
Reverse rope dropping.
Okay, we rerouted these plans to replan what we had planned for tonight.
I'm a genius.
We're all proud of you. You did so great.
Keep chewing
on
camera.
I don't really know what you're doing. It looks great.
Very lovely. Hello. Hello, neighbors.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm very introvert with everything. Like, it's weird.
There are neighbors coming.
I feel like those people are probably like, what the heck is that guy doing with that camera? Like,
talking
to him? Weird. They're so funny. They're so funny.
That's ridiculous, Mo. And transmission.